What's up, YouTube? Today I'm going to be sharing you my thoughts on the Speedcubers documentary. So, yes, I've watched the documentary on July 29th, and I watched it the second time today. And after watching the documentary twice, I officially loved this documentary. It was inspiring and emotional. So, how I will share my thoughts in this video is that we'll split the video into three sections. One is on Felix Zemdegs, one is on Max Park, and the final one is on the WCA World Championships in 2019. With that out of the way, let's start the Felix Zemdegs section. I love that section, that 7-minute section. It was too nostalgic. It took me back 5 or 6 years ago when I watched Felix Zemdegs for the first time. And when I started watching more videos, I saw how he got so fast and became the dominant champion in speedcubing, and so is the icon in speedcubing. And I really saw how speedcubing changed his life forever. I got more deeply into his story on how cubing changed his life forever. And I learned more about his cubing career, like how he became so fast, like what made him so fast, and what caused him to motivate himself to cube more. And even though he's a really competitive cuber, he's really caring for others. So, like, he doesn't show poor sportsmanship towards people who are slower than him. And overall, that he's just a really good person. And really shows the true meaning of him. Now on to the Max Park section. I have to say it's really emotional. Like, during the Max Park section, I saw Max Park cry before he started one of his solves. It was just really sad. I really felt bad for him. And I took pity on his parents so that, because his parents couldn't achieve in anything because of Max Park's autism. And I realized that the cube is like the antidote for Max Park's autism. So it like cured his autism and it helped calm him down and pay attention to other things. And I noticed that Max Park doesn't really think that he's an icon. He mostly looks up to Felix Zemdegs, who he idolizes. And he loves cubing as much as he loves his family and friends. It's like cubing is like one of his friends or family members. And it really made an impact on his life. And I really like that section of the documentary. Now let's talk about the WCA World Championships. In July 2019 in Melbourne, Australia. It was a bit unrelated since Philip Vyer won the World Championships. Neither Felix nor Max won. They both lost, which is a symbol of equality between the cubers. And at the World Championships, Max was faster than Felix. His average was faster in the World Championships 3x3 finals. But they don't really care about it. They're still best friends with each other. And they still maintain the rivalry and the friendship. And seeing Felix cry at the end, I really felt bad for him. And I was about to get emotional as well, but I decided
I'm not doing that.
I'm too mature to do that. So that is it for my thoughts on the documentary, The Speedcubers. I really love it a lot, and comment below your thoughts on this documentary. And have you watched it or not? You should definitely watch it. Be sure to like, comment, share, and subscribe. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you in my next video. Bye.